Hello, and thank you so very much for joining me tonight. I go by Lune and INNATE, and I always forget to mention this, but please like and subscribe if you enjoy my videos. It really helps the channel. Comments really, really help. And if you'd like to support the channel and support me, Patreon is a great way to do that, and I'm gonna have my classes, my Reiki classes, back in March, okay? Get that out of the way. I wanted to create a really relaxing video for you today. So I'm just gonna talk to you a little bit to kind of get you in the mood, help you shift gears, because what we're gonna be doing is a cord cutting ceremony. When you're sleeping. Now, of course, you can use this while you're doing the dishes, you can use this while you're journaling, but I'm trying to craft it in a way that's really supportive. If you want to take a nap or meditate and drift or fall asleep. For those of you who like to know what's coming up, we have some shears, some various shears. And we have some smoke and feather, some spray, and a little bit of crystal fossil kind of work. Okay, so as we get started here, I want to set an intention. I've already lit 8 candles behind me for that harmony and that balancing and to hold space. But I just want to set an intention to support you in clearing, cutting cords that are in any way tethering you, manipulating you, pulling you in any direction that is not of a sovereign identity, not a sovereign vibration. We want to work in the emotional realm, so the emotional cords that you may have to a circumstance or even person outside of yourself that is kind of gunked up, it is tainted in some way, or forgive the word here, but I call it like a dead cord. Even if you want to plan to revive that cord and give it a fresh start, bring in a new dynamic, we can work to clear and cut away at these emotional cords that are in any way inhibiting you, your authenticity, your prime connection. We're going to work in the mental field, so the mental field as well, to cut cords of belief, as in false belief, limiting belief, impeding belief, limiting, did I say that already? Harmful, misaligned belief. All of that, they're working with the smoke and feather as well. And we're going to cut karmic cords. Karmic cords that are ready to be healed. If I might give you an example, in some capacity, now this is obviously personal, forgive me here, but I really want to give an example here because I think the concept of karma is quite big, you know, and we can read into it in a lot of different ways, or it means different things to all of us. We all have our own understanding or perspective on something like karma. But what I mean by karmic cords, as in, let's say the troubled relationship that I had with my mother, particularly while she was in body, because she's on the other side now. And instead of feeling like because we couldn't heal during the time that we were together, let or have a good relationship during the time that we were together, now do I feel this burden? Do I feel this? Oh, we have to work this out still. We're gonna have to come back and work on this. I mean, I'm sure I'll have to come back, but since her passing, and even a little before, I really feel like that karmic cord can be healed. We can come to an agreement that we've done enough and we did our best, and even though she's over there and I'm over here right now, or at least this part of me is here, we can heal. We can still have a beautiful dynamic versus this feeling of a karmic obligation to go and do it all again, you know? So if there's any karmic cords perhaps that you even feel like you're living in this life, known or unknown, that are perhaps unnecessary or looped or taken on in some kind of form of devotion or dedication in a way that wasn't necessary, it isn't necessarily beneficial for your soul, maybe your soul has the message already kind of thing. We want to cut that. And we also want to cut cords if they are in any way lineage-based, so that you can, you know, a lot of us feel this way. We are the one that is breaking a lot of family or lineage cords, you know? We're really doing a lot of healing in the generations that are present in this life experience right now. So that's what we're going to be working on. Some of you love the intros, some of you can't stand it, but I really think it's necessary to prepare the consciousness. Most of the time, 90% of the time, it's helpful to prepare the consciousness before you're sleeping. And also so you know what this is supposed to or intending to help and support you with, okay? Just want to take a quick moment before we get into it and introduce our partnership, our sponsor for this video, which I'm thrilled to be working with again. It is the Aura app, and they are so amazing. I really, really, really have enjoyed this app so much. I recently did the 7 days of grief journaling by a creator named Doriana, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm excited to do one that she has on self-love, because that's something I'm working on personally right now. I feel like I love myself, but I really want to show myself that I love myself, so I'm excited for these journaling prompts so that I may reflect and create any more action. Not just tell myself I love myself, show myself. Aura is the most robust mindfulness and sleep app that I've ever experienced. Their catalogs are stocked with a myriad of themes from sleep, sounds, stories, CBT, which is cognitive behavioral therapy, breath work, life coaching, spirituality. One of my favorite things that I've discovered about this app is that you can customize every single meditation and choose the background sounds within it. So for the journaling, at first I was doing some watery sounds, rain and waves. And then I moved, as we got to the 6th and 7th journaling days, to just the crackling fire to really kind of tune into that transformational energy. Aura's content is created by hundreds of expert coaches and therapists from all over the world. And in fact, I even see a friend here, Reiki with Anna. I freaking love her so much. I've been blessed to meet IRL and work together. And I love Anna so much. How awesome to see her here. I really also love all the different voices and how each guide our creator here really radiates in their own authentic voice. I don't mean to be negative or anything, of course, but some meditation apps get a little boring hearing the same voice over and over, like the same two voices. As I said, there's literally hundreds of different coaches and therapists and specialists here. So you get such a variety of authentic souls out there trying to make a difference and put out something good and healing and beneficial for all of us. See why Aura has won the Best of Apple Awards and is used by over 7 million people. So, you can get started completely for free. The first 500 people to use my special link in the video description below will get a free trial of Aura and also an exclusive 25% off a membership of Aura. It's such a robust app. I'm so happy to be using it. I think I said this before, but it's amazing how things work out and how tools show up for us along the way. And Aura is certainly one of those sort of like, in that moment, life-changing tool or resource that you can have to really support yourself through whatever you might be going through. So I hope that you'll take advantage. Thank you so very much to Aura for partnering with me on this video. Thank you so much, viewers and subscribers. Would not be able to do this without you. All right, and now we're gonna get into our session. With the deepest emotions, the superficial emotions, even if I can say sort of like the false, I don't mean to say that any of your emotions are false or not valid, but ones that after you're done feeling it, you're like, why did I feel like that? It feels so big in the moment, and with a good nap or a good meal or whatever, it's like, actually, I think I'm going to spray my hand for you. And just channel through, just some support before. Feeling, letting it just roll down, roll away, clearing anything that has not yet formed a cord, and we're just tending to the garden, so to speak. Enveloping you in just a very healing, safe field, channeling through to your aura, this very comfortable indigo blue with a fiery sheen to it. Remembering this can also be just a fresh opportunity for a new dynamic, a new relationship, a new any toxic dynamic, any imbalanced dynamic slip away, be released. Up from a dream. With a fresh perspective. With a confidence. Perhaps a value of self. A self-prioritization. Clear the excess here so that your emotions are tempered. We can clear attachments, a tether you may have placed on a person or a situation, as if something outside of you is in control. As if your happiness and fulfillment were dependent on something outside of yourself. You can clear that tether, cut that cord, pop that bubble, and just regain that harmony. Perhaps you're also dealing with some grief of some kind. Perhaps you feel let down, or there is heartache. Let's clear that if we can, at least lighten it. Clearing the emotional haze from how you perceive things, giving everything a fresh start, taking away its the power it has over you, if it is encroaching, if it is manipulative, clearing right over your vision here. Mental cords, okay. a little less smoke on my hands. Gonna work around the mental field again, just channeling through. Are bendable, are flexible, and they can limit us, and they can open all the doors, and all the potential, and all the possibilities. We want to work with also cutting the cords of attachment to certain paths, like paths of pessimism, paths of that lack-mindedness, paths of jealousy. Of it never works out right. using the path. That make you feel alone or isolated or without support. These are just examples, of course. Just sense between. always take a vow of chastity because I'm a nun or I'm a monk and I am taking, and now that's infecting like how you maybe connect with yourself from like a sexual aspect. Just again, these are just examples to kind of like open the little doors of chewing on things for you. But we're gonna use this first, just intend as I'm channeling through continuously through this whole session. Just kind of access. Thank you.